My name is Tawana, and I'm on the board of the James and Grace Lee Boggs Center to Nurture Community Leadership, Boggs Center for short. We hold a lot of political study and discussions here at the center with community organizers who are doing their own work in Detroit, and not just Detroit, globally. And so we hope to not only shed a light on their work, but also encourage visionary organizing and political study. One of the things that Grace always talked about was, with every crisis, there's an opportunity. And so that isn't a viewpoint that I had before I came to the center. You know, I saw everything for what it was. And I was not thinking deeper about, you know, if you see blight, what could that become? Why is that blight? You know, I was just thinking about some of the things that I would see. That's an abandoned house, that must be an abandoned community, because that's what propaganda teaches you. But since I've become a board member, and even just coming to the study circles and the things at the center, I'm able to vision beyond the obvious. I'm able to think deeper, think historically. The center has helped me to not walk outside and fall into despair every time I see something that, you know, I'm not happy with. I start to think about what we could vision moving forward. And so that's been very helpful. And I was able to pour that into my son, who's now a philosopher. Ironically, I love Detroit. I don't see myself living anywhere else. And so I'm really grateful to be part of the change that's going to come from the grassroots and not from the top down. The poem I'm going to perform for you today is Dear Detroit. And it's one of Grace's favorite poems. And so I'd like to give you my Detroit poem. We were supposed to turn our backs on you. Count down to your imminent demise, dangle you by the limbs of misdeeds. They wanted us to rate you inferior. Plagued by deteriorating neighborhoods and a convoluted history, you were never supposed to bloom from your ashes. A lot like you have been discarded like debris, deemed useless to naysayers and convictors. Yet you keep rising, clinging to vitality. You refuse to allow statistics to dictate your destiny, and the media will channel your journey. And though some shall remain loyal, others will mock your tribulations. You were combing a younged into maturity. Both your gift and your curse, imported from adversity. You've seen better decades, yet you thrive during the worst of them. Your best days have yet to arrive, and though some won't stick around to witness your climb or rejoice in your restoration, your destination is inevitable. You've been on the bottom much longer than most, and the bridges you'll journey won't be easy to coast, but you will make it and bring warriors with you, armed with devotion. They will defend your dignity and honor your namesake. You are Detroit, the road to progression, the mirror image of endurance. And you hold the key to taking back our democracy.